I've done dates with Herbie Green for 33 years, and Herbie Green's played with everybody. And when he comes to the session with a camera in his trombone case to take a picture of that session, I know something special's going on, because these guys go to sleep on everybody. I mean, because they're that good. And when I saw Herbie's camera, it almost made me cry, because, you know, I knew it was as special as everybody else felt it was. And that's very rare that that happens, you know, regardless of what happens, to get that many people to come with that much experience and background to come ready to give up everything that they've trained themselves for their whole life for, to put it on the line for this night, because it was important to put it on the line this night.
So we want to cut it so that it's all right. How many times, Francis?
Well, about three times.
It's all right. Okay, I know we do. No problem.
You know, you take this recording fest that we had, it was a special sought-out invitation to the greatest. First, we had the greatest of all greats, Frank Sinatra, the singer. We had Quincy Jones as arranger for this great session.
Take it 61 more time, please.
We had sidemen such as George Benson, Ray Brown, Joe Newman, and Frank Foster. I could keep on naming all of them.
From the Lionel Hamptons through Jerome Richardson, and here's the Young Brecker Brothers, and crossover of a lot of musicians from rock and roll and jazz.
I learned 23 years ago when working with Frank and Count Basie that it's a good idea to really have your homework done and have everything well planned, because he's a perfectionist. And if we come in 3 hours early and get all the balances done, get all the notes straightened out and everything else.
Just let's milk him now.
1, 2, 2, 2.
At 181, I don't think you should catch all those accents, man. I think you ought to just chop wood in there.
George,
you got the four-bar solo, and then you guys basically, you and bass carrying the company behind the vocalist, George.
Well, what was going on in the room before Frank arrived was the kind of tension you'd expect at Yankee Stadium before you go out in the World Series.
I need somebody with thinking cap.
We got two inputs right here. I got them.
Me being completely over the top, trying to figure out how I'm going to get through this. Fears that I hadn't had in years.
I think that somebody of that stature, that everybody respects so much, there's an electricity and a heat when he walks in the room. I don't think intimidating is the word, but I think there was definitely a current in that room.
Hello, guys. Well, say hello to everybody before we get going. We may not be here very long. I better say hello now.
Because he doesn't like to circle the field too much, you know. He doesn't like to linger. He condenses his energy and puts it all together, and as a perfectionist, he goes for it at the moment. And you might not get more than one or two takes, and so it's good that everybody's ready, because if he goes and gets his, you know, he might start without you.
Hey, Q.
Uh-huh.
So I know exactly where the trumpets are in the phrase. We take it for 41.
Okay.
And I want to lay out when they get up on the top of the next phrase.
Okay, 41. Go. Bar 41. One observation I've made over the years of working with Frank is that the one thing that transcends him being concerned about his image as the greatest pop singer in the world, and he certainly is that, and this is what I love about him, is that he has his basic respect is for his love for music and his roots. And his roots really come from being a big band singer.
Try to hit. I see for you. I'd even punch out Mr. T for you.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, because I want to let them lay the note in there first. Yeah, that's, I couldn't hear the pitch in there.
Yeah, there's a lot of funny chords on it.
Ba-da-da-da. What is love gonna have to do until the real thing comes along?
Sounds great, man.
Yeah. Well, it's a little cold yet. A little cold yet. It'll warm up a little bit. Let's try one, huh?
Okay.
A singer is really measured, I suppose, by equipment in three areas, intelligence, vocal equipment, and emotional range. And certainly he has all three in abundance.
And that's why he's one of the great interpreters, and who makes your both
your melody and your lyric sing.
Don't you know I'd work for you? I'd slave for you. Be a beggar or a knave for you. If that isn't love, it will have to do. Until the real thing comes along. Gladly move the earth for you. Prove my love, dear, and its worth for you. If that isn't love, it'll have to do. Until the real thing comes along. With all the words here at my command, I just can't make you understand. I'll always love you, baby, come what may. My heart is yours, what more can I say? I would cry for you, even sigh for you. Tear those stars down from the sky for you. If that isn't love, it'll have to do. Until the real thing comes along. Walk on burning coals for you. I would drive the Chrysler, leave the Rolls for you. If that ain't love, it'll have to do. Until the real thing comes along. I would try to hit high C for you. I'd even punch out Mr. T for you. If that ain't love, it'll have to do. Until the real thing comes along. There's not a thing that you can ask of me. Go on, demand any task of me. You want the moon for a lavalier. All you got to do is nibble on my ear. I would rob, steal, beg, borrow, and lie for you. Lay my little body down and die for you. If that ain't love, if that isn't love, if that ain't love, it'll have to do till the real thing comes along.